folk. Amen. And those who are so stuck on self that, amen, that we love to take selfies. I cover the ground I stand on.
Right. He ain't right.
But you ought to make sure now that you're not self-righteous in your selfies.
Yeah.
Because self is a part of the trinity of evil, of Satan, sin, and self. Have I got a witness? But you ought to be mindful this morning, children, that the Lord knows how to take care of your worst self. And the reason why some folk can't grow in the Lord, it ain't the other folk in your way. Self is in your way. I feel my help. It ain't all that you need to do to blame somebody. Every now and then. MJ said you got to look at the man
in the mirror.
In the mirror. Yeah. That's right. What he reminds us.
All right.
He said, listen, he said, I'm on my way back and I'll take care of self. Uh-huh. That entity that will always put that barrier between you and God. Are y'all with me here?
Yeah.
Then look at the function in the text. The word says, Jesus rising from supper. Have I got a witness in it? You see, y'all heard me say it. What we've done to accommodate folk, we've moved this table from supper time to brunch. Because folk won't come back. For supper. But there was a time. Amen. We knew that when the street light came on. Supper time wasn't far away. How many know what I'm talking about? And so he said, he rises from supper. Watch him now. And the word says he laid aside his garments. Notice now. And took a towel and girded himself. Culturally wise, he shouldn't have been doing any of this. Because this was the position, amen, of the lowest slave in the abode. And here Jesus is, knowing who he came from and where he was going back to, laid his garments aside. If you notice the atmospheric conditions in the text, he's not even suggesting that I'm more than who I am. But he knew who he was. And yet he didn't announce it in the sense, why y'all looking at me serving you? I should be looking at you serving me. But the record says Jesus came into the world. Yeah. Not to serve. Huh? Not to be served. But to serve. I wonder how many of us are motivated after we leave the table on first Sunday to really serve somebody else.
All right.
Are we so caught up in self-serving our sinful self? Jesus said he took a towel and he girded himself. Verse 5, and I close on that. The word says, and he, notice, he took the water in a pitcher, no doubt, and the word says, and he poured it into, a basin. And y'all know I'm from the country, and we, yeah, they had these, yeah, the pan that sat by the bedside at night, and y'all know where I'm going with that. And if it was too cold, y'all ain't helping me. Some of y'all, I don't know nothing about that. But some of my folk, it ain't shame. Yeah. Of where the Lord brought you from. Yeah. Yeah, that pan would have its proper place. Yeah. And they had that pan. He poured that water into a basin. And the denomination that I come from, when we would do communion, we would have that basin. And the minister would have the water in the pitcher. Amen. And the deacons would hold their hands as he poured the water into the basin and washed their hands. Are y'all with me here? But then further on from that, there's not just a hand washing. There was also a feet washing. I wish I had a praying tonight. And he poured the water into the basin. And the word said, and he began to wash his disciples' feet. But I like the fact that he poured water, into a basin. Because the water is the cleansing property. Are y'all with me here? You can have all the soap you need, but if you don't have any water, amen, you're going to be missing some things. And the folks you go around going to know you've been missing some things. Preach, Pastor White. And so what I said earlier is that, this man, Jesus, he's pouring the water into the basin because the water has cleansing properties. Never got any witnesses yet. And when you recognize that water holds weight in and of itself. And enough of it can move, amen, a whole, mountainous of things out of the way. And the weightlessness of it can also cause the Titanic to sink. Have I got any witnesses? But oh, bless his name. He poured water into a basin and began to wash his disciples' feet. And if you notice, there's no soap involved here. Why? Because you need to know that the Savior himself is the sanctifier. Oh, yeah. He knows how to clean it up and set it apart. Yeah. He knows how to clean it from the not only outside in, but the inside out. He knows how to clean it up in time and eternity. That's his name. He knows how to get you right when you're standing in a crooked line. He knows, how to wash your mind. And have I got a witness? And I asked the Lord this morning, I was praying and praying over the message. I said, Lord, what about this water? Just tell them in the end, and I'm closing there, y'all. Just tell them that his water has got cleansing properties. Have I got a witness? In other words, it'll deal with your character. It'll deal with your conscience. Yes, it will. It'll deal with the very aspect of your being. And aren't you glad this morning to know that man can clean you up? But it took the water, the cleansing holy properties of our God's water to clean you up this morning. Have I got company right there? That's why when we are baptized, we're not baptized for cleansing properties, but we're baptized Yeah, for identification purpose. Have I got a witness? In other words, we identify with the Savior who was dead in the grave, but he's been resurrected to the newness of life. And that's where you and I come in. When we hit that water behind me, we may feel like I just went out dry and came up wet. But the real issue is you went down dead and came up alive forevermore. Have I got a witness? Let me close there, y'all. If I can help me use my imagination, if water and dirt had a conversation, dirt would say to us, well, I've been here a long time, and the longer I sit, the harder I get. Have I got a witness? Well, what you gonna do about that, boy? Well, let me tell you about this here dirt. I've got a few properties of my own, and every now and then, I don't run from the bottom up, but I run from the top down. And if you let me hit you enough time, y'all ain't helping me now. If you let this dirt, this water hit that dirt enough time, sooner or later, that dirt is gonna have to dissipate. Am I not a witness here? Come here a little closer. When you come to church every Sunday, and the water of this word start hitting the dirt in your life every now and then, it don't start to evaporate. Now I got a witness here. Oh, I'm glad that I've been hit by him water. Have I got a witness here? And his water will clean me up. Have I got any help in here? Aren't you glad, children? That one glad morning, you got hit by his water. Hey, his water will do it for you. So as I close this morning, remember this one thing. When I was coming up in the country and we came in to supper, mama then would say, don't you come to this table until you go back out there, boy, and get the grit off of you. Y'all ain't helping me right now. And some of y'all in here, you need to let the Lord get the grit off of you. Have I got a witness? Before you come to this table, let the Lord shake the sand off of you. Have I got a witness? Oh, bless his name. I'm closing there, but my soul got happy because I'm from the country on both sides of my family. My mama's side got red dirt. My daddy's side got white sand. And that's a whole lot of grit together. If I got a witness here, but ain't nothing gonna move that but the water of the word of God. If I got a witness, ain't it all right? Ain't the Lord all right? I know it's all right. Woo! I got a close that. My soul looks back and wonder, hey, how I made it over. If I got a witness, over hills and mountains, over valleys and streams, but I'm in here this morning to give God the best praise that I have. Now I got a witness. Y'all ain't helping me here. Hey! Give God glory today. Now I got a witness. I got clothes there. But when Nisha was a baby, we took her. She went with us to see the color purple, and we could barely watch the movie. get up and walk out and walk around with her. Have I got a witness? But one scene stands out to me. As Whoopi had already been beaten and had already been abused. I love the line that she said. She told old old master that, now I may be black. All right, help me. Y'all gonna make me jump down here. I may be ugly, but I'm still here.